tune into this week's Xamarin Show, where I have my good friend Javier on, talking about control templating and all the possibilities that it brings. So tune in. Welcome back, everyone, to the Xamarin Show. I'm your host, James Montemagno. Today, I have one of my best friends in the entire world back for like the 18th time, Javier. How's it going, Javier?
Hey, pretty cool, James. Happy to be here again. Who are you?
I'm doing great. Happy New Year. Welcome to 2021.
Yeah, the same.
Yeah, everything's good here. You know, I'm excited because we have a lot of exciting videos lined up for this year. I know you and Gerald just did some recordings. It's a very exciting time for Xamarin developers.
Yeah, there are very nice videos related with things like the community toolkit and other stuff that will be very, very excited.
Yeah, I'm super excited because I keep going back and watching all of our videos that we did last year on shapes and paths and SVGs and all the really cool advanced things that are now inside of Xamarin Forms 5. And my understanding is that there's some really cool features around control templating that you've been working on for a while and the team's been working on for a while that you want to share with us today.
Yeah, so the thing is that you can create controls for Xamarin Forms in different ways. You can, of course, use and create custom renderers, but we know that many developers in the community create some controls just using a content view and putting their content there. But the interesting part about that is that now, as you have said, we have brushes, so we can paint almost whatever we want. We also have shapes, so we can draw also whatever we want. And we can also clip views with any way. So that gives us a lot of possibilities to create custom controls just using Xamarin Form element. And it's interesting to create a content view, but what if we do not create a predefined structure and allow our developers to modify in any time, in any moment, this visual structure of the controls? And that's the topic that we are going to see today.
Very cool. Yeah, because I feel like a lot of people for a long time have thought, oh, every time that I can't do something, I have to create a custom render. I have to go through this sort of advanced, you know, step. But it doesn't really seem like that's the case anymore. So I'm really excited about this. And I'm excited because I've watched a lot of your tweets that have come in over the holidays specifically and some really cool things that you're doing. And of course, things that the teams are doing. But yeah, I'm excited to take a look at what you got in store for us today.
Yeah, so for that, let me start sharing my screen because I want to start talking about very quickly about some concepts. I know that many people probably know about that, but I have the feeling that the control template concept is maybe a topic not very well known. And in fact, it exists from many years ago, from many versions of Xamarin Forms ago. And the concept is pretty easy. We are going to see that with some samples. I'm going to start with this sample. You can find this sample attached with the official documentation. I'm going to start using the official sample. And the concept of control template is pretty easy. It's just a piece of code that enables you to define the visual structure of a content view, custom control, or a content page, derived page. So it allows you to define what will be the visual hierarchy, what will be the structure of the control, and you can set and change the visual structure dynamically in execution time in your application in any moment. So that's the more exciting part about the control template. To create a control template, you need to use the control template type. It allows as root element only one element, one view, but of course it could be any layout, so you can create the layout as complex as you want. And then after create the control template, you can assign this control template in the control in that way. Because as we have said before, you can create, for example, a control in that way, it's a content view where you define all the appearance in that way. And of course, in the code behind, you have some interesting BW properties just define the behavior and the appearance of the control. But you also can do something like that, where if you take a look, it's a content view, that's right. But wait, what is the definition of the UI? It's not here, right? Because we are doing something like that. We are creating control templates and assigning the control template in that way. This is how we are setting the visual hierarchy of our control. And then there are a couple of two more concepts that I want to mention. One of them is if we go to the control, we see here template binding. So we know that we have different markup extensions related with bindings, but what is template binding? So template binding is a markup extension that binds a property of an element that is inside in the control template to a public property that is defined in the templated control. This is very interesting because we can use customize the appearance of the behavior of this visual hierarchy with direct bindings to the BMW properties that we are defining in the control. At the end, it's exactly the same or equivalent to set the binding context of the root element to the control, right? And use binding markup extensions, but it's a easy way to do that. And other very interesting topic is the content presenter topic. And we are going to talk a lot about controls today, but we can do the same with page. This is a content page where we are defining here some visual structure with control templates. We are defining some header and some footer in this way. And then with the content presenter concept, we can do something like the following. If we go to the control, in the middle of the control, we have put here the content presenter word. What is a content presenter? It's just a place in the control template to mark where we will inject content, we will display content that we are going to define in the templated page. So this content presenter will show content that we are defining in this page. At the end will be this content. So if we launch this sample, well, this is the template card, of course, working as you can see, but the UI, remember, is not predefined in the content view. We are using control templates, and the same could be done with page. This is our page. This is from the control template, and we can reuse that in a easy way to allow to have many pages with the same header, with the same footer, or with the same menu, or whatever that we want, and then just inject the content that we need in every page. So this is a very interesting concept. And in fact, in Xamarin Forms 5, we have introduced the ready button controls, right? This is not a very exciting demo. It's used a stack layout with three ready buttons. You know,
it's beautiful. Not... It's beautiful. I love it. Well, I think it's
beautiful, but you know what? We can do it more beautiful because the ready button is the first control that we have in Xamarin Forms with control template support. And that means, let me launch this sample. This sample is Los Gatos. It's a sample created by David Ortinau, where if we navigate to, let me find where I have the simulator. If we navigate to the settings page, we can see that this is the same. It's used a ready button that we have defined in the UI, but we have created this control template, mostly replicating the ready button from Fluent Design. Of course, we can also use complex bindings like support, uptime binding to adapt the UI depending on the system. Then we can also mix and set some behaviors based on visual states. So you can define everything in the UI, and at the end, the only thing that we need to do is set the control template property to the control template defined. In that way, we can override, sorry, this is another demo, we can override the behavior and the appearance of the ready button in a single way.
Okay, so really when we think about it, you have, what some developers are used to is like creating a custom control inside of a content view. The problem there though is that if you want to create a different card view, you're going to have to duplicate that like 100%. Like here's card view, dark, here's light, here's whatever, swipe this, this, and that. Whereas, and then you have to like update and duplicate the bindings over and over again. So now you have different bindings, where here it's a template. So it's saying, it's like, here are the properties that exist on this card view for the first demo that you showed. And then you just implement the template, whatever you want it to be. So that means if I want my card view to have, you know, different corner radiuses and different things like that, I can change it. And all I have to do is update that one string, the template that I want, instead of replacing the entire element there. So I could easily just say card view, because I know a card view has these properties. It's like, here's all the different 10 different styles of card views that I may have. Exactly. Instead of 10 different controls. Yeah.
That's exactly the main point, because for example, if we put the focus in this card view control, we can continue adding properties to, for example, you have mentioned the corner radius. That's right. We can include a corner radius property. We can include a property to manage if we allow shadows or not, et cetera, et cetera. And probably with a good set, well done about, well thinking about how many properties we need, what are the properties that we need. Probably we will need we will cover the 90% of the case where we want to use this card view. And that's fine, but of course there will be some applications where we will need something different. And in some cases, the developers are just copying the control, moving to the new project, and adding just a single new property, modifying, you know, the UI in the content view, and adapting the UI. And in fact, it's not exactly necessary. You can create the properties necessary to manage the basic appearance of the control. And if you want to allow yourself in your next application, or if you want to create a library and allow to other users to create their own UI appearance, their own visual hierarchy, it's possible using control templates. And in fact, it's what I have done in this library called Template UI, where there are a big amount of controls like avatar view, bat view, chart mover, circle progress, compare view. There are some charts. All these controls are templated controls. And that means that we are doing them in the following way. Let's see, for example, a single control. So let me navigate to the library, open a control. For example, let me open something simple to see, like the toggle switch. At the end of the toggle switch, it's just a template view. It's a view existing in Xamarin Forms. It's the same than the content view, but with one new property that is the control template property. So you can create the control. I have not defined anything related with the UI here, because what I'm doing is create some resource dictionaries. I have a toggle switch dictionary here where I have defined with the control template what is the UI. What if I need in the control to access to any element from the template? It's also possible, because there are some methods like on apply template, that is when we are applying the template, and you can use the get template child method with an string with the name that is defined in every element in the template to access in the code to the control. So if you want to modify something like an apply an animation in C# code or whatever that you want to do, it's also possible to do. And in that way, you can create things like this. Let me open a sample, for example, the toggle switch. So this is the Cupertino, the Fluent, and the Material switch. At the end, it's not native control, is a templated control created using shapes, because now we can draw this corner radius and these ellipses in a perfect way. And the only thing that I'm doing in all the cases is exactly the same control, The only thing different is that we have three different control templates that are defining what is the Cupertino appearance, what is the Fluent appearance, and what is the Material appearance. And the only thing that we are doing to set what appearance we want is set this control template using the control template property in the control. So you can create really, really complex things. And if you want to modify anything from this, that is exposing the same properties that the switch that exists in Xamarin Forms. But if you want to, I don't know, create a zoom with a triangle and fill with an image, okay, let's go. Go here, go to the control template and define that. Yeah, I'm not exposing any property about that, but it's possible to do that. And in the same way, there are other controls, like, for example, the segmented control is a good example, where all this is possible to customize with properties. But if you want to create something extremely different, this is, again, possible just creating control templates. So again, control template is just a concept that exists in Xamarin Forms from some time ago. It's just a piece of code that allows you to define the visual hierarchy of your controls. And you can create derived template controls from content view and from content page. It's also possible with page. The main concept are you need to use the control template to define the template. It's also possible to create in C# code, of course. And then assign the template using the control template property. And if you want to access to the template, it's possible also from C# code using the getTemplateChild method. Not many concepts, but you can increase the possibilities a lot with controls created with a composition of Xamarin Forms element using templates.
Yeah, it's really cool because what you're saying is that there could be this world, like with a radio button sort of started it, which is this is the first sort of built-in templated control. Like you could always create your own, but with the radio button, that's the first step into this sort of built-in control templating, which means that hopefully in the future, I think as we go towards like .NET MAUI, I think one of the goals there is to make everything templatable, right? So you could kind of change dramatically any of your, you know, different UI elements. I think it's really neat because oftentimes you may want a radio button, but you want it in a bunch of different styles. So instead of, you know, replicating that control and copying and pasting anywhere, you keep it very organized and to the point. And then the radio button, which already is a templated control, has all the properties for you. So there's nothing special you need to do, but it's really nice to see the flexibility of what you can do because those controls that you built and showed right there look like tons of work with tons of custom renderers, but they're just templated controls.
Yeah, exactly. There are any renderer in all this library. And in fact, it's just a portable .NET library, a single library. There are anything specific with any platforms, all the controls are defined here in this library. And all the controls are templated controls. So now with Xamarin Forms 5, where we have things like shapes, like brushes, like many other functionality related with manage the themes based on the system then, et cetera, mixing all that with concepts like control template, we can create really, really, really powerful things without need to go and jump to the native code. And this is a very interesting concept, and for sure is something that I hope we continue exploring, and we are doing some tests and investigation in that for the future in .NET MAUI. So hopefully we will have more templates in the future than the ready button. But that's the beginning. You can start playing with that today with Xamarin Forms 5, playing with the control template in the ready button.
I love it. I will definitely, I now kind of understand it a little bit more because I've looked at it a little bit. I didn't quite understand it, but now I really kind of grasp it. And I think your library is a great example of what, you know, we can do as developers, but also control vendors and community members that are creating controls. So Javier, thank you so much for showing this all off and really describing on what these templated controls are.
Thanks, Jane. Has been a pleasure. See you in the next one.
Well, thanks everybody for tuning in. Of course, I will put links to all the documentation, all the samples that Javier showed today, and of course, links to our previous videos where he went through how to draw shapes, do paths, do RGBs, all these things that would be really helpful when you're doing custom templated controls. Javier, thank you again so much. And thanks for everyone for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe. Click that like button. Give us a thumbs up. You know what to do. So until next time, I'm James Montemagno, and this has been The Xamarin Show. Hey, James here. Just wanted to check in and thank you for watching this video. Now do all the things that you know you want to do, such as like, subscribe, and ding that notification bell. Become part of the notification squad. While you're here, check out all these awesome videos that I've already recorded. Click on that thing. Click it. Watch it. Do it.